Samsung Goodlock 2020 is out for quite a few days, and many of you have been asking me about its installation in the non-supported regions. So in this video, I am going to show you how to install the Goodlock 2020 in all the regions that do not support it, and also I am going to give you a brief review of the new application. First things first, for those of you who do not know what is the Goodlock 2020, it's a UI modification and customization application. The Goodlock first surfaced back in the 2016, and since then Samsung has been refreshing this application with new features every year. So what Samsung does is, it gathers the user feedback about particular features, and the features that are most liked by the users, they end up being a part of the next UI update. For example, in the Goodlock 2019, we saw a very polished one-handed mode and also a screen recorder. We got both these features in the new Android 10 and the Samsung One UI 2 update. So the features that we are about to see in the Goodlock 2020, they might end up being a part of the One UI 3 or whatever Samsung is going to name its next UI. So first of all, I am going to show you how to install this application. Remember that at the moment, the Goodlock 2020 is available in South Korea, the US, the UK, Canada, and a couple of other countries. So if you go ahead and search for the Goodlock 2020 application in the Galaxy store, you will not find it there. Also, if you end up installing the Goodlock 2020 using its APK file, you will still get the error that the application does not support your region. The only way to install the Goodlock 2020 right now is to use an alternative. It's just a management panel for all of the Goodlock modules. So what you should do is go to the Google Play Store on your phone. I am using the Galaxy A51 here. And here, look for an application named NiceLock. Now install the NiceLock application, which is the launcher for the Goodlock. NiceLock also got an update with the Goodlock 2020. It also supports Android 10 now. Guys, do remember that the Goodlock 2020 does not run on the Android 9 powered phones. You must have the Android 10 and the One UI 2 to launch the Goodlock 2020 modules. The NiceLock app is installed now, and you can see that it's listing all the modules of the Goodlock 2020, but none of these modules are installed right now. You will have to install all these modules manually on your phone. I am going to drop the APK links of all these modules in the description so that you can download them right away. And I will get back to you with all these modules installed now. You can see that I have the APK files of all the modules here, and I am going to install these one by one. We have now installed all the modules of the Goodlock 2020. You can see that some of these modules are appearing as the standalone applications, but you can also launch them using the NiceLock application. It's totally up to you. So in the NiceLock application, I would like to show you that all these modules are installed here. It's also telling me that there are some modules that have a new update that I can install. And also if I go to the menu here and I go to the Android 10 and module status, it shows me about all the modules that have been updated for the Android 10. And there are some updates expected in near future. For example, the LockStars compatibility is coming on February 13. Navstar is expected at the end of March. And then all the modules are updated. So these modules still work with the Android 10, but these just do not have the new changes that Samsung has announced in its changelog of the Goodlock 2020. So these are all the modules that are installed, and I'm going to talk about the ones that have got the updates now. First of all, we have the Multistar. Multistar is among the applications that have got the biggest number of changes. First of all, it has got the ability to launch the multi-window or the pop-up view by simply pressing and holding the recent key and the back key. Also, the multi-window has got the pop-up screen execution. You can now adjust the size of the gesture area. Other than that, you can now set a particular application that will not be killed even if you kill all the applications on your phone. This is a feature that's appearing here. If you enable the long live app and you select an application, it will keep running even if you kill all the processes on your phone. Also, if you change the position of the pop-up window on the screen, the phone will remember the position and it will launch the pop-up from the same location where it closed from. You can see that the multi-sound is not appearing here anymore. It's faded out because it has been moved to the sound assistant. The next application is a LockStar. It's not working right now, but it's expected to get the update by the end of this month. There are some changes that are going to change the internal behavior of the LockStar. Samsung is going to add the ability to automatically arrange elements to match the background. There is going to be a notification detail view that was requested by the users. The lock store is also going to provide a lock screen auto time off setting, and with the One UI 2.1, Pace widget will be resized as well. There are other UI settings coming as well, but we will have to wait until the end of this month to get all these changes. Now, next up is the Quickstar application that has got the changes with this update. For the Quickstar application, Samsung has improved the color segmentation and the visibility. Also, now you can change the clock's position. First of all, you can see that we have the panel settings here. We can select any of these panels, or we can create our own panel using these color combinations as well. The clock position now gives us the option to either hide the clock, or we can set it to appear on the right or the left side of the status bar of our phone. As you can see that it's changing its position by turning on or off these options. Similarly, there is a new panel in the task changer. If you remember the task changer application used to change the look of our recent applications panels, I have currently set it to tiles. This is my favorite layout for the recent applications. The new option here is a vertical stack. The vertical stack looks like this. You can select any stack of your choice from here. You can also center the currently running application in the vertical stack. The Notice Star application has got an option to add a custom entry point from the lock screen. In the Notice Star application, you can go to its settings now. And in the settings, you can change the start icon settings on the lock screen. You can change the position of this icon to start anywhere that you want. This is a really nice application to look through all of your notifications and even search through your notifications right from your lock screen. The Navistar application has also got some updates. It hasn't received the updates right now, but the updates are in progress and they will be here very soon. The Navistar application has got one of its most wanted features back, that was to hide the navigation gestures on the screen of your phone. You can also select any of these button layouts from here. The theme park application has now got extended manual color settings instead of auto. You can now design a theme from scratch. You can select any wallpaper to start creating your own theme. For example, if I go to the camera and I select this picture, it will let me create a theme that will match the colors of this wallpaper particularly. For example, in line with the wallpaper that I selected, it's showing me all these color combinations and layouts. I can change the colors from here, I can also change the style, and I can also change the on and off look of these icons. The one-handed mode has got the auxiliary handle now. You can add it anywhere on the screen. You can also add a quick toolbar function for the mobile data and the game booster. You can also execute various activities by expanding the home screen shortcut function. Also, there is a new vibration feedback setting. Color change of the animations is now possible. The last application that is going to get updates for the GoodLock 2020 is a sound assistant. These updates have not arrived yet. These updates will be here by the end of this month as well. However, it's going to get a menu to provide a vertical style of the volume UI. Also, as I mentioned earlier, that the multi-stars, multi-sound function is now available in the sound assistant application. The remaining modules of the GoodLock 2020 remain the same. If you want to learn about these modules, let me know in the comment section down below. I am thinking of doing a series of videos about the GoodLock 2020, with each episode covering each specific module of the GoodLock 2020 application. If you are interested in such a series, make sure that you drop your feedback in the comment section down below so that I can start working on it right away. And if you have any questions, make sure that you ask them in the comment section down below as well. With that said, I will sign off and I will see you in the next one really soon.